Hello, and welcome to another Ye Olde Battle Reps Warhammer Fantasy Battle Report. Been a while since we've
What
done
the
one of them.
hell?
Yeah. It's certainly the first battle that me and Dan have fought in probably almost a year with Warhammer Fantasy. And I've, for some reason, picked up some ogres, and so we're doing ogres versus Warriors of Chaos. And we're doing a meeting engagement, which is where you deploy diagonally across the board. Dan deployed his whole army first. And we have to roll to see who's in like reserve, I think, isn't it? Who doesn't start on the battlefield. So we'll just go over what's in our armies and then we'll get started with the battle. Okay, so my ogres, starting over here, 4 iron guts, 10 nobblers with trappers. It's not marked in there, but he's got trapper. A saber tusk. This is 10 bulls with a butcher, and there's supposed to be a fire belly in there, but he's starting off the table. Another saber tusk, 9 iron guts, a slaughter master, and a BSB. And this unit looks a bit crappy at the moment because they won't sit on the hill there, but they're not quite as far forward as that. 6 lead belchers, 3 man eaters. These are, I think it's called Titan Forge models, really cool looking, like pirate man eaters. And the good old versatile, what's it actually called? Magma cannon, isn't
Magma
it? Yeah,
cannon, yeah.
which
He's
seems to turn up in every game, some form or another, and being used for
proxying or
something.
some other
Yeah,
something.
so this is obviously an iron blaster. Yeah, it's not the prettiest looking army at the moment because I've picked most of them up second hand. Oh, and also off the table are my Mournfangs. Unfortunately, rolled one for them, so it does mean they can't get a shot of magic in the first turn, though, so that's maybe not such a bad thing. The Warriors of Chaos, so.
So I've got three Skull Crushers. They've only got actually a champion, they haven't got a standard Bane Musician.
Okay.
20 Forsaken. This is a level 2 wizard, obviously of Nurgle, on a demonic mount. A War Shrine. 20 warriors with great weapons.
Pretty nice looking
And
unit.
there's a BSB in there as well. Level 2 Sorcerer of Slaanesh. Hell Cannon. This is a Chaos Lord on a dragon. He's popped up in several battle reports of ours before. And off the table, I've got 6 trolls and Throg.
Yeah, yikes.
Yikes.
And my firebelly's not on the table, so that's brilliant. So at least both your regen unit and my counter to it is not on the table.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is pretty much it. And what we have to do now is I roll to see if I steal initiative.
Yeah.
So let's
You're
do
a
that.
six, then you get it.
I'm going to use this magic dice.
Because I've been rolling sixes on
I
those.
rolled like 4 sixes in a row with it. So let's see. No, it's not six.
So
Okay.
I get the first turn.
And for magic, I've got a level 4 Slaughter Master with Spine Marrow, Bone Crusher, Troll Guts, and Bull Gorger. A level 2 Butcher with Tooth Cracker and Spine Marrow. And a Fire Belly level 1 with Fireball. And Dan's just got 2 level 2s. Miasma of Pestilence and Rancid Visitations from Nurgle. And then from Slaanesh, Pervain of Slaanesh and Slicing Shards, which I think are not very good,
Nope.
are they? Awesome. Right, so we'll come back to you after the end of Chaos Warriors movement. The Warriors haven't really moved much. These units have pretty much stayed still. Dragon has. Bit of shuffling here and there. Skull Crushers have shuffled. Neither of these frenzied units had to charge. And then Throg and his trolls have come on over there. So what I thought might be a nice little flanking unit is obviously not going to be able to do anything against those trolls. And that's it. I think no one else really moved, did they?
Yep.
Okay, apologies for the sound in the background. If you can hear it, it's just the boiler doing something. So, pretty good magic phase for Chaos. It was only 4 power dice versus 3 to spell. But this thing casts its spell with irresistible force, and what did it do? It gave +1 strength to the Battle Standard Bearer, +1 strength to the champion of that unit, +1 attack to the Lord. So, not a bad spell at all.
Yep.
Okay, so shooting phase. The first thing, the skull can
The Hell
hell
Cannon.
cannon
That's
has
fine, these guys.
fired the iron guts. The guy under the hole, it didn't wound, but then it meant it hit 8 people round him, and I think wounded
Wounded
all
all of
8.
them. Got all the eight.
So
So killed two and one thing, got
one's the one
one
left.
left. Jack has to take a leadership test at -1, so because of his Slaughter Master and BSB, it meant he's basically leadership 8. He's
Yeah,
failed
so
his first leadership
I've
test.
got +1 leadership banner on that unit,
Yeah.
so the leadership 9 down to 8. Failed the first leadership test, rolled 9.
And this is the next one. Are they going to flee straight off the board?
Oh, God. No, they're fine.
They're fine.
Yeah. Okay, so it's Ogre's end of my turn on movement. I actually back these guys up because I don't want to get charged straight away by the trolls, but I think they might still be close enough to charge me. But I tried to bring the Noblars round to block the trolls, but where they were positioned, they couldn't really get very far. I sent two Sabertooths in front of these units. And this unit has moved up a bit. Advanced with the Iron Guts, pivoted around with them, managed to advance a bit, and what else?
Mournfangs come on over there.
Mournfangs have come on. Pretty much the only clear way was to bring them on over here and come around there, but I think they might be better off over here now that I look at it. But yeah, so it's some magic. Okay, so my magic phase, it's I think 9v5, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Started off with a 2d6 fireball from the firebelly who came on here at the trolls, who's just in range of, and Dan let it through, hoping that I wouldn't roll too well. I got 7 hits, and here is my wound roll. Look at that. One wound. Fuck. And the remainder of my magic phase, I cast the troll guts on the Iron Guts with 4 dice, but Dan dispelled it with 5. And then I failed to cast a magic missile on them. Okay, so it's the end of my shooting phase. Yeah, pretty lackluster phase, really. The lead belt just got, I think, a fair number of hits on the warriors, but they only killed 3, which is not too bad.
Well, you rolled above average for the number of
shots.
Yeah,
it's all averaged out in the end, isn't it?
It did kind of all average out.
The man-eaters got a wound through on the dragon, which is pretty happy about. and then this...
I am laughing.
Shot and got a clear hit on the Hell Cannon, but then the Hell Cannon saved it with this demonic 5 plus ward. I think that was all my shooting, so it's Chaos Warriors turn 2. Okay, so Warriors of Chaos turn 2 movement. The Trolls have charged the Nobblers, took a dangerous terrain, but then they regened it. They did take a wound.
Yeah, that was from the fireball.
Skullcrushers charge him, and the. What are they called? Berserkers?
Forsaken.
Forsaken. Charge that it's supposed to be a Saber Tusk, it's a Direwolf model. And they've sort of pivoted quite well to overrun potentially. Then we've got a double charge from the big block of warriors and the Chaos Lord onto my Iron Guts, so pretty worried about that unit. And that's it. Then this has sort of moved up a bit as well. Okay. So Chaos Magic Phase. The first spell cast was a 5 dice, whatever that's called. Blessing of Chaos. Basically, another irresistible force from it, which has no negative effects for Chaos. And it gave the BSB and the champion plus 1 attack. So I got plus 1 strength and plus 1 attack. So the other spell, I think, was Miasma of Pestilence cast onto the warriors, but I managed to spell that, fortunately, because that would have been pretty disastrous. I mean, it's looking pretty disastrous anyway for this unit. I don't know, but that would have meant...
They're a tough unit.
Yeah, that would have meant I only hit you on 6s, though, so that would have been shit. So, in the shooting phase, the Hell Cannon took aim at the Mournfang, and surprise, surprise, got a direct hit again. But, same as last time, the guy under the hole down rolled a 1 to wound. So, he was fine. I did take 1 wound on the unit and thought they would have to take a panic check. We realised that it's only if you take casualties that you take that test, so that's quite fortunate. And so on to combat. Okay, so it's the end of this combat here. And it's, not gone well for the ogres. So, I accepted a challenge from the BSB with my Slaughtermaster, because it meant that I didn't have to take attacks from the dragon. And that was... I think that was pretty much a stalemate, wasn't it? I think you might have done... I think I saved all the wounds you did, and I don't know if it did any to you.
Yes.
Other than that, I just took a ton of wounds from the Chaos Warriors, and I killed...
Well, mainly from the Lord.
The Lord, the Dragon, did loads, and the Lord did like 4s by himself. And so I think that's 4 Iron Guts have died, plus 2 wounds on another one. And in return, because they're Mark and Nurgle, I only killed...
Three.
Three guys. So yeah, so it's going to be Snake Eyes, unfortunately. Don't have the ranks there.
Yeah.
So let's do it. Go for it. Nope. Not that time, but I've got BSB. So there's always hope. Oh, almost. Half a Snake Eyes.
Half a Snake Eye.
yeah, so it's going to be a Fleeing
Time. So those
time,
two die.
So. Yep. Oh, they're both standards. Yeah, they do, don't they?
Shit. And these guys flee.
Yep, let's do it. Okay, I'll do that off camera because it's too awkward. Okay, so it's Ogre's turn two. Over here, I just thought, fuck it, just charge the Ogre's in. I can't just keep backing up and, you know, never know, they might get a lot of impact hits, although I've already shot the charge and they didn't. But charge these at the Forsaken. I don't think we mentioned last turn, the Forsaken only rolled like a 3 on their overrun, so the idea was to overrun the Forsaken into this unit, but that didn't happen. Fire Belly's moved over here. Mournfang have come round from the side and then back these guys up so they can see the dragon, and they've come round to see the dragon as well. And back this up a little bit to shoot at the dragon. And that is it, because my main unit is gone. Okay, so it's the end of shooting. I'll just summarize the magic phase first of all. It was 3 powered ice to 1 dispel dice. I cast the +1 strength spell with my butcher over here. But Dan just scrolled it because I didn't manage to irresistible force it, so that was that. And then shooting, fuck's sake, fucking Iron Blaster misfired and then span round and just do nothing. Look at it, it's facing the wrong way. There's a dragon there, so it's going to get charged by the dragon to die next turn. Managed to put a wound, another wound on the dragon, so that's not bad. It's 2 wounds so far. And the lead belchers fired at the warriors and killed 5, so that's pretty pleased. 4 was it? Yeah, so there's 10.
No, 5.
There were 15 and now there's 10. Yeah. So, pretty pleased with that as well. They've done,
they've done
quite well.
Yeah, they've killed 8 warriors.
Yeah.
Which is a lot of points, because warriors are very expensive.
Yeah, in 2 turns as well. So, that's it. Just this combat, or these 2 combats over here.
Yep.
So. Okay, so it's the end of combat. Over here, the trolls took like, put a wound on Throg and maybe, I think, killed 1 troll. But then Throg did his breath weapon and obliterated the unit, and they've reformed. And then over here, I did break through. I won combat by 3, and the Forsaken fled, and the Ogres caught them. But it does put me in quite a nasty position, because the trolls have reformed, obviously with the mind of that happening. So, yikes. So we've got some points for the Ogres, at least. And now it is Warriors turn 3. Yeah. Okay, so summary of the Warriors of Chaos magic phase. Basically, at the start of the phase, I declared I was using the bullshit item in the Ogre's book, which is called the Hell Heart, because his wizards were fairly close and my butcher might die now. So so it made his Nurgle wizard, who was right there, miscast and die. Did cause a large round blast, which hit my Ogre's and killed one. And then his other wizard lost all her wizard levels. So,
so I've one spell left now.
So actually, that's...
So every turn, that guy's going to be casting a lot of last spells.
Yeah, so you can probably guess what happened. He cast that spell and irresistible forced it again and gave his... I think you exalted hero got +1 toughness.
He's now toughest 5, strength 6, with and five
attacks. And your champion...
Got 7, which
can
is
like
the worst roll. Yeah.
Can re-roll once or something.
Yeah.
Yes, but that's the only magic he has left now, so at least my Slaughtermaster dying isn't too much now.
Slaughtermaster dying.
Right, shooting, the Hellcannon's going to shoot at the Mournfang, so what's going to happen?
Misfire!
You did roll a hit though, you have rolled a hit every time on that.
8. Oh, I don't want 2 dice. 5.
Basically, it just stops there because it would hit that obstacle. It's supposed to go forward, so nothing happens. It doesn't shoot.
Yeah.
Yeah. So just this combat then, isn't it?
And that combat.
This dragon over here. Yeah. Okay, just after combat. I don't think I mentioned before. I think Dan might have forgot to move them, but if they're in a shot before. But the Skullcrushers have come round to behind the Fire Belly. So after combat, Ogres lost. I was steadfast, but failed. Fortunately, I got away. So I fled 10, he pursued 5. The Chaos Lord easily, well, I think won by about 5 against the Ogre. Didn't kill it, but I fled and he pursued me off the board. So he's not actually there, he's off the board by this hill.
We're putting there for safety.
Yeah. And that's it. It's ogre's turn three now. Okay, so after the end of my movement phase, my ogres didn't rally. They were over there. They ran off the board. That's my two big units gone. I've charged, basically, with the way that Dan had cleverly angled his war shrine, that's what it's called, in front of these warriors last turn. These Mournfang wouldn't fit through the gap, so I've had to charge there and hope that I overrun the warriors. But that doesn't mean I can shoot them with everything now, and possibly magic them with the firebelly. So that's it. I haven't really got a lot of units left, but let's see what happens. My magic phase, it was just when you don't want fucking like loads of die. I just wanted a nice, easy magic phase to cast a fireball on them. But I got like 10 dice, that meant that Dan had 6 to dispel with. So I cast fireball, got a crappy roll, and Dan resistibly dispelled it. So, yes. Shooting was really good. Lead belchers and managers combined killed like 6. There's only 4 warriors left now.
3 warriors left.
Oh, 3 warriors and a BSB, yeah. Yeah, so it was just combat with the Mournfangs. Okay, so after the combat with the Mournfang, I did 3 wounds and took 2 in return. 1, and he fled 7, but even with Swift Stride, I only pursued 4, which wasn't enough to even take me into the warriors. It's not too bad, because the warriors basically have to charge or be charged or be shot now, so not the end of the world, but it's a bit annoying. So that's end of ogre's turn 3, and it's on to warriors turn 4. Okay, so warriors movement. The war shrine rallied and has turned to face firebelly, and the trolls have come round to face firebelly as well. The skull crushers have come all the way around here from where they were. Dragon has just flown over there to basically hide. Ogre's just attacking Dan over there.
And the warriors
have charged more of them because they might as well. Otherwise, they're going to take impact hits next turn.
Yeah.
Okay, so shooting the hell cannon fired at the lead belchers, got a hit again.
Because it's apparently amazing.
So it's actually hit every single time, so 4 times, but just one of the times it also rolled a misfire, so the hit didn't count. So it hit the lead belchers, did a bunch of wounds, and then they took a panic test at -1 and failed, and have now fled nearly to the board edge. It's as good as being off the board edge because the skull crushers are there to charge them. So bullshit. Right, so it's combat.
Yeah.
Wow. So that combat went pretty well for the Mournfang. It would have actually been better to have killed less warriors to give them more to kill, to get more combat res. But in the end, I won combat by 1, killed all the warriors, because only 1 by 1 the BSB stuck. But that's a lot of points from that unit, so that's quite handy. That's it, so ogre's turn 4.
Yep.
Okay, so it's coming near to the end of the battle now, ogre's turn 4, and there's not much left for the ogres. I've moved the man-eaters over there because I don't know if the dragon will charge them. And also, I was kind of stuck between the skull crushers and the dragon. And they're just not going to be able to handle either of them, so I'll just put them over there. The firebelly did make a charge into the rear of the BSB, though, to help the Mournfang out. And that's it. Okay, there was no magic because my firebelly was in combat and the shooting didn't do anything, so I did just about manage to put 2 wounds onto the buffed up sort of void rage BSB, which had been pumped up by that thing. So killed him and then just reformed this way. Otherwise, I might have been flank charged by the skull crushers. And that's it. So it's actually gone to turn 5. It looks like Chaos are winning by quite a lot, I think, because the combined total of their units and their lord's going to be more than what I've got. But turn 5, see what happens. Right, so Chaos Warriors turn 5. Yeah, the skull crushers get off their frontal charge into the Mournfang. Get an oppressive presence from these two units coming behind me. And in a very unsportsmanlike fashion, I think Dan has charged the rear of my man-eaters. But basically, after, well, depending on what happens this turn, but this is pretty much going to be it because the Lord will make short work of them, most likely. I think it might be stubborn, though. I think I'm getting poison stubborn, I can't remember. But they'll probably just kill them outright. Yeah, and I think skull crushers are quite a bit better than Mournfang, I mean, they're certainly a lot more expensive. So that's likely to be over. So So, magic? Magic. The only spell that Dan can cast is the
War Shrine spell.
War Shrine thing. And you roll 4 dice. For fuck's sake, look at that shit. Another irresistible. So the hell cannons hit every time. It's got an irresistible force.
3 times.
3 times out of 4. And not always exciting it. So, yeah. So it's going to just affect
3 people.
3 people, which can be. So oh, you 1, can affect like, 2, champions 3. This corner, yeah.
Yep.
Cool. I wonder if we get Demon Prince. Oh, okay, so it was close.
9, because there's not much point in giving a 6 plus ward save.
So we got just irrelevant results on the Sorceress and Throg, like plus 1 attack and stuff, they're not going to use it. And then rolled 11 for the Skullcrush champion, so not quite a Demon Prince.
Well, no, yeah, well, I'm not going to take the 11 result anyway, because I'd rather take the plus 1 attack.
Yeah, cool. Right, so could help to tip that combat. Lying around somewhere. Cool. Okay, so it's the end of the combat, and the Mournfang just got absolutely butchered by this, what they called, Skull Crushers. That wasn't pretty. I took like 6 wounds or something. I only did 1 in return, and that was only thanks to the Dragonhide banner, which I figured I could use in that charge, because the way it's worded. Just like wilted. They really need to charge and not be attacking like 1 plus save people.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I fled, and I've got Swift Stride, so I rolled 3d6. That's my roll. 3 twos. But Dan rolled his Swift Stride. Got the same roll. That's weird. No, that is weird. So he catches me, but in a weird way.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I remember the weird thing.
So, yeah, I think that's it. They've only got 5, but you've got to kill the Man-Eater, so we'll do that. See whether we can kill the Man-Eater. Yeah, so Man-Eater combat. Dan had to issue a challenge, and I accepted with the champion, thinking I was being clever. So I was like, oh, well, you can't kill the unit now. Didn't kill the champion, and I attacked back and did 2 wounds to the dragon with the champion, which made me think, if I hadn't have done it as a challenge, I could have, like, maybe killed the dragon and maybe, like,
yeah, but I rolled quite badly with the Lord. If I rolled one better with the Lord, I would have killed him.
Yeah.
And then I would have won by even more. I mean, it's rather than kill a stubborn.
I think taking the challenge was probably right, because I'm stubborn Leech of Bait anyway, so I stuck. But we're just going to call it there, because, I mean, there's no one left. Yeah. I've got my fire belly, so, I mean, I think they're scared of fire, aren't they? So
not that scared.
Fire belly. But, yeah, it's a big victory for Warriors of Chaos, but it's a fun game, though. And it's quite interesting. I think I've never played Ogres before. In fact, I think one of the last battles we did was a mirror match of this, where I used Warriors, you used Ogres, and that time Warriors just about won. But I think there's a bigger victory this time for Warriors. So we'll total up the points and put them on the screen. Okay, so we have totaled up the points. Ogre Kingdom scored. I actually managed to get 1,168 in the end, which is not too bad considering it felt a lot worse. But Warriors got a massive 2,842, just a crushing victory for Warriors of Chaos. And I quite enjoyed using the Ogres, that's the first time I've used them. And yeah, they're just different. The reason I picked them up is they're just completely different to the other armies I've got, which is High Elves and Dwarfs. Yeah, brutal, bloody battle, and a lot of luck on both sides. I had really good luck with my shooting, but then Dan's magic, well, wasn't devastating magic or anything. It was just really the War Shrine.
Yeah.
It's not like you had like crazy spells going off. It was just a few irresistible forces. The Hell Cannon did, because the Hell Cannon made the lead belchers flee off the board, didn't it, I think?
Yes,
a couple of other things. But yeah, enjoyed that battle. That was good. And nice fun to play fantasy again as well. So that is it. Thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you next time.